étudiante au Business Christian College. Je peux parler l'anglais, le français et le chinois.
That's not English, Leon.
Ah. Ni hao, wo hen gao xing ren xing ni. Wo jiao liao.
That's still not English.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Still not English.
Guten Tag.
Sorry.
I'm so good at so many languages, they get mixed up in my head sometimes. Learning at MCC, I learned not one, not two, but four different languages out of the many that are here that are on offer. With Chinese and French, I learned them in our curriculum, in the classrooms. Sorry. The languages are getting mixed up again. I have the HSK 1 and 2 Chinese certifications, as well as the DELF A1 and A2 certifications, thanks to MCC. I have also learned Spanish and German through very dedicated clubs at the school. Even better yet, when times are not so tough and COVID is permitting, we have French tours for your little ones that they can embark on, as well as the opportunity to participate in the Chinese Bridge competition abroad in China, and this can win your child scholarships, as well as the opportunity to go to China on a holiday. Yesterday, me and a group of other French students went to Loewe to participate in Francophonie, which is a competition for spelling, grammar, and French culture. Unfortunately, we came second, just by 1 point. We'll get them next time, guys. And with these languages, you can apply for universities abroad. All of this is very specific to the language department. At MCC, the subject range is split into departments that are headed by a teacher and can be seen by our heads of academics, Mr. Sachinda and Mr. Sam, all very qualified staff members for the job. These departments are languages, commercials, sciences, humanities, technicals, and the IT department. In the languages department, you'll find subjects such as French, Chinese, English, Shona, and of course, Devin. With each student that passes through MCC being required to have a GCE English qualification, many of which will then continue to do first language English, which holds weight as a qualification that you can apply to when going to university and even in interviews for jobs. Under the commercials department, you'll find accounting, commerce, economics, business studies, and other subjects like that. In the sciences department, you'll find biology, chemistry, physics, computer science, and maths. In the humanities department, you'll find literature, history, divinity, and geography. And in the IT department, you'll find ICDR, which someone else will touch on very soon. And in the technical departments, we have art, design and technology, fashion and textiles, as well as agriculture. And many of these subjects have presentations that are going on in the side foyers and in the back foyer.
Sometimes I wonder, if all our parents told us that they were top in the class, who exactly was second? But that's a story for another day. But the only instance where you'll find everyone is top in the class is MCC, where the education is top-notch and the academic competition so tight, no one comes second. Now, why do we have a wide subject range? To cater to a wide range of students with different interests, personalities, and strengths. Within this, you'll find that we offer a wide range of not only subjects, but examination boards, such as DELF, which offers A1 and 2, B1 and 2, and advanced French exams, HSK, which is a Chinese examination board, where each MCC pupil is required to at least make it to level 2, and ZigZag for anyone wishing to be tested under this board, and our most trusted and stable examination board, and arguably one of the best examination boards globally, Cambridge, from GCE, IGCSE, O-level, A-level, and AS and A2 level, we offer it all. In fact, Cambridge, we offer it in our lessons, and it is the syllabus that we push through in the classrooms. But on top of all this, MCC is adaptable. There have been numerous occasions where a student may want to do an exam or a subject that is not exclusively offered on the curriculum that you will see in your packet. But MCC has made a way for these pupils to still sit down for these exams, to take these subjects, because we believe if they're interested in it, if they're strong in it, then they have the right to do it. Now, I know what you're thinking. I'm all talk. Don't worry. I'm smart too. or at least MCC made me realize I could be. For my O-levels, I attained 90 stars, 2 A's, 1 B, and 2 C's, and for my AS level, I attained 20 points, which in other words, is 4 straight A's. I know, don't you wish I was your child now? But you actually, well, I actually could be your child. Well, metaphorically, of course, we do not condone kidnapping. In this word, I mean that your child, if you send them to MCC, one day they could be just like me. Because MCC just doesn't leave students to swim in the deep end by themselves. Instead, they provide counseling, they provide catering and nurturing for them. So much so that even if your child is an average student in primary school or was just like I was, MCC will take them to be the top student that they can be. MCC.
Locally adapted.
And locally relevant. Choose MCC, the best for your child.
Good morning, parents and prospective parents for the year 2023. My name is Tawana, and today I will touch on a topic that you as parents generally have mixed emotions about, and that has to do with gadgets. Here at Woodlands Christian College, we believe that the implementation of technology in our learning is very important and very useful, which is why we allow our students to have devices such as iPads, tablets, as well as laptops. These gadgets can be used for study as well as research, so that your child is never behind in class. We also have 2 computer labs and a library equipped with desktops where kids can access Google Classroom or study in a peaceful environment. In addition to that, all of our classrooms are each equipped with an overhead projector as well as a desktop, which allows for more engaging and exciting lessons, where educational material such as videos and notes can be shared to the students. Now, inasmuch as we all know that we are currently living in a pandemic, the reality is that things still have to happen. And one of those things is learning, because you find that exam boards like Cambridge won't change exam dates just because cases in Zimbabwe are rising. In fact, Cambridge is actually expecting your child to be ready for that math or English exam. And to ensure that your child is ready, a platform called Google Classroom is used. Through this platform, teachers are able to post work, notes, videos related to the subject, as well as give individual feedback to learners. Parents can also register to their child's Google Classroom so that they can monitor the progress of their child and see what they do. Yay! The use of Google Classroom at school is made easier through the good, fast Wi-Fi we have at MCC. I could sense some unease among parents when I mentioned Wi-Fi. But don't worry, your response is not surprising. It's actually very understandable. Because one may ask themselves, does this good, fast Wi-Fi not expose my child to undesirable material? Well, the truth is, it does. But we at MCC make sure that it doesn't. And we do that through Fortinet, a firewall that restricts students from visiting explicit sites and monitors what learners will be searching about. So anything flagged as explicit will be seen, and our IT team will know who the owner of the gadget is. Yay! Fortinet is also programmed to disable the Wi-Fi at 10 p.m. and enable it at 7 a.m. We want to make sure that our students are not up all night on the internet, but instead they should be sleeping and resting. In fact, studies have shown students who get enough sleep are more focused and have a better concentration time, as well as a better academic performance. Now, I know for some of you this may sound very extreme, but we as a school know that you have all invested greatly in your children. So the least that we could do is actually make sure they're doing the right thing. So I hope to have you guys join our wonderful school next year. Thank you.
Good morning, parents, boys and girls. I'm Chris Jeruma, and I'm going to be talking to you about the sports MCC has to offer, specifically for the gentlemen. MCC, the land of opportunities. We love to bring out our young people's strengths and skill set in sports. MCC offers a variety of sports for the gentlemen, which include cricket, rugby, hockey, basketball, volleyball, swimming, as well as track and field athletics, and even football. Not only do we offer large amount of sports over and above normal sports time. We have extra practice in the evening and even weekend sessions. We also have the teacher supervision during these after-hour sessions, which have certainly paid off. As I stand before you, I have two Zim Blazers, one for rugby and another for hockey. MCC also has an upcoming gym for our Eagles. I'm sorry in advance, fathers, if your son gets home and he's too big. But all of this is in order to better our Eagles. Now, how old can you be to start a sports team?
With 25 world championships, 19 of those gold medals, the world-renowned gymnast Simone Biles started her elite career at 14 years old. That's just about your age, right? Right? Yes. At MCC, we strive to develop our athletes at a very young age. And to cater for every child and their different skills, MCC offers a wide range of sports for the ladies, from athletics, cross-country and swimming, to netball, basketball, and volleyball. Speaking of volleyball, I was actually selected into the Zimbabwe volleyball team. Talk about a dream come true, right? We later on traveled on tour to South Africa. Believe it or not, I wasn't the only one selected into the national team. I went to South Africa.
Where did you go?
Well, I went to Zambia. And guess what? I got to play and to tour with different national teams. Believe it or not, we are not the only Zimbabwean national representatives at the MCC. Over the past 3 years, MCC has managed to produce over 20 national representatives. These teams have been able to travel to places like Germany, Belgium, Zambia, South Africa, and Malawi. We have 9 dedicated coaches, and of those 9, 3 coach at the same level. I wouldn't have made it if it wasn't for the facilities that are provided by MCC. Speaking of facilities, we have 2 swimming pools, 3 basketball courts, 5 fields, 6 volleyball courts, 4 tennis courts, and 4 cricket pitches. And I hope to see you prospective Eagles playing on these fields next year. Thank you.
Morning, parents and Eagles for 2023. My name is Nigel, and I'm going to touch a bit on the cultural aspect of MCC. MCC is one of the venues for the National Institute of Allied Arts, which is a vocal and instrumental festival. On Monday, we were privileged to host and participate in this event. Our band and our choir managed to attain honors for both their pieces. So I would like us to take time to listen to our band perform their honors.
Thank you.
aside from our lovely band choir, we have a number of clubs. We have MasterChef, Things, Robotics, Chess, Sign Language, Science at MBA, First Aid, Girl Enhancement, Archery, Drama, and even Toastmasters. As my friend Nigel alluded to, we participate in the National Institute of Allied Arts. This term we had the Music Festival, which is the instrumental and vocal. We also have other festivals, such as the Speech and Drama, the Literary Festival, and the Visual Arts Festival. Aside from the NIA festivals, we have a number of platforms where our students get to showcase their cultural gifts, such as internal public speaking and band competitions, and external public speaking and debate competitions, such as ATS and NASH. We also have external band competitions, such as HIFA and Madison Zimbabwe. As was said before, MCC is a land of opportunity. Thank you.
Salutations, parents, guardians, boys and girls. A wise woman once told me, there is no one on this planet who can teach you what I can teach you. I think we can take an educated guess at who this mysterious lady is. Yes, my African mother. Just like any other parent, she wanted the absolute best for her child. However, this was ages before I was introduced to this wonderful institution. Here at Midlands Christian College, a vital constituent of our agenda is to make sure our students are well equipped for the world, just as if they were to live their entire adolescent life with their stern mom or strict dad. Today, I have with me my driver's license, a certification that I acquired through the school driving program that we have. I remember being there, the VID, praying with all my heart that the car doesn't go back at the hillside. God willingly, it didn't. In accordance with this, we also allow our day scholars who have attained their driving license to drive to and from school. Yes, mom and dad, those early mornings do get easier. Furthermore, due to hosting students from all over the planet, or who eventually graduate and venture to faraway lands, one of our priorities is to develop the survival skills of our students. Therefore, we ensure that every pupil learns to swim as we prepare them to be versatile instruments in any situation. Our life skill program also encompasses teaching one to change a tire, sew a button, mending clothing, gardening, upkeep of personal hygiene, career awareness and development, community awareness, networking, time management, teamwork, and finally, emotional intelligence. These are introduced in day-to-day school life and during the four camp excursions we have throughout one's high school career. A combination of these arrangements has proved to produce exemplary and adaptable characters.
A pleasant morning to you, loving parents and future eagles. My name is Joanna Mshede, and I have one question for you grade sevens this morning. Who here is nervous to come to high school? Anyone? Wow. Don't worry. When I was in Form 1, I was nervous too. But MCC has programs to help with this. For our females, we have Treasure Girls. And for our males, we have Iron Sharpens Iron. In their separate settings, Form 1s will be taught how to navigate teenagehood with biblical principles. They will be taught about self-worth and identity. They will also be given guidance and counseling about some of the struggles teenagers go through in today's life. These are life skills that every individual needs to go into the outside world a confident and independent someone. So take it from me. MCC is truly the place to be. Thank you.
Good morning, parents and prospective eagles. I am Nadine Mutangara, and from the moment I came to MCC in Form 1, a vast number of leadership opportunities was offered to me that I simply could not refuse, such as class monitor, subject monitor, sports captain, club captain, college monitor, and college steward. At this moment, I am pleased to say that I was a class monitor, a college monitor, and I am currently the vice president of the Journalism Club, the Toastmasters Public Relations Officer, steward, who is the head of academics, and head of Crown House. It is because of these various internal leadership roles that when an external opportunity to serve in my community came about, I felt I had what it took for me to try out leadership at that level. In doing so, I became, and I am currently, a counselor for the Gweru Junior Council for Ward 5. And in this council, I play a role as the director of health services, and I ensure that all children of my community are healthy and safe. Alongside me is my counterpart in heading academics here at MCC and the director of engineering and city planning for the Junior Council. He's going to tell you more about the council.
I am Tegiwa Manyakaize. Similar to Nadine, I too had various leadership opportunities presented to me within the MCC system, such as being class monitor, captain for the entrepreneurship club, college monitor, and college steward. It was through the MCC leadership grooming that I even began to seek for more opportunities within the community. As I stand here, I am a promoter for the National Blood Service of Zimbabwe and junior counselor for Ward 6. MCC has taught me the value of servant leadership, which then allows me to execute my duties efficiently and truly make a difference in my city, from spearheading donations to the less privileged, to putting as many underprivileged children as we can through primary school. Being a voice for people is not exactly the easiest task that exists on the planet, but the system nurtures you to withstand pressure and advocate. Now, without further ado, allow me to introduce to you our Madam Deputy Mayor, aka our boss, Jessica Manambo.
As the junior deputy mayor of Gweru, I get to rub shoulders with highly esteemed personnel like the president of Zimbabwe himself. It is an experience I will never forget because I am given the chance to influence decisions made in parliament. And the overall bonus, my personal favorite, is that I get to stay in expensive, luxurious places and enjoy well-prepared delicacies without paying a single dollar. In fact, they pay me for my services. All this could not have been possible if Midlands Christian College had not groomed me into the leader I am now. It all started with small things like class monitor, stream representative, peer promoter, and vice president of the robotics club. And now I get to lead a whole city at the age of 15. Yes, I am evidence that the life skills program and guidance given at MCC do bring out the hidden talents in individuals. Now, I'll pass the mic to a distinguished honorable gentleman. He secured his position as the junior mayor of Gweru in his Form 3 year. He got to meet the president. He also became the president of the National Junior Councils Association of Zimbabwe and managed to secure his position, all in Form 3. In his term of office, they called him His Worship. And now he is our head boy, Kauma Kaamaze.
Good morning, parents and prospective eagles. As aforementioned, my name is Kauma Kaamaze, and I'm the Midlands Christian College head boy for 2022. As you've clearly seen, before we were all selected into the junior council, we first assumed leadership positions within the confinements of the college. MCC identified the very special leadership skills within us, then nurtured and trained us into the leaders we are now. MCC constantly provided us with internal leadership positions and opportunities. Okay, so here's a small snippet of my internal leadership portfolio. At first, I was a class monitor, tennis captain, form monitor, college monitor, Toastmasters Society and Journalism Club president, and now I'm currently the college head boy. All this then led up to my appointment as the junior mayor of the city of Gweru and as the president of the National Junior Councils Association. MCC adequately prepared me for all these positions. So if your child comes to MCC, then they flourish in internal leadership positions and opportunities. They have the opportunity to be part of the junior council and the junior parliament. Midlands Christian College is definitely developing and nurturing globally adaptable and locally relevant leaders, your future CEOs, managers, and politicians. I would like to be the president of Zimbabwe one day. Best believe that that dream comes true. So MCC definitely is a place for your child. It's a land full of opportunities. Thank you.
Wow. Do I really need to say more to convince you that MCC is the place for you and your children? MCC truly is the land of many opportunities. Now, it is to my understanding that we've got people from many different parts of the country outside of Gweru. So most probably your children will become boarders. Now, I know you're probably wondering, what are the facilities offered in hostel? We'll hear more from that from Ma'am Rachel.
MCC offers a number of facilities that makes a student stay worthwhile. We have medical facilities. A student's health and emergency administration is top priority at MCC. There's an on-campus clinic that is overseen by our very qualified nurses and a doctor who's always on speed dial. In case of emergencies, every single staff member is qualified in first aid to ensure a student's safety is on point. There's also a holding bay that is for isolation purposes. This has been proven useful ever since the COVID-19 pandemic struck. We also have laundry facilities where our laundry staff make sure every single student wears a clean and neatly ironed uniform. And for mothers who are worried about their children learning how to wash, we wash and iron our own casual wear. We also have a dining hall where students have their meals. This is where our highly trained chefs prepare different delicacies for us, from chicken and chips, chocolate cake, ice cream. Every single meal is unforgettable. Aside from these facilities, MCC is there to groom your little boy and girl into responsible ladies and gentlemen who are ready for the outside world.
Now I will be talking about Castrol House. A mere grain of regular dirty sand finds its way into an oyster's shell. The oyster covers the irritating grit with layers of a shiny substance its body produces over many years. Eventually, the grain is encased, becoming a pearl. Castrol House has become my oyster shell because it transformed me from being a mere grain of sand, a Form 1 child with absolutely no clue of who I wanted to become a pearl, into this astounding and virtuous lady that I am today. From teaching me how to speak, to be neat, confident, punctual, well-mannered, well-behaved, proficient, eloquent, and elegant. Looking back, I'd have never seen myself as Miss Castrol, a lady of virtue, and the deputy head girl and head of marketing 2022. I owe the lady that I've become today to this very college, and leaving won't be easy for me this year because truly, it has become my home. As much as Castrol House's main objective is to groom and produce God-fearing, smart, and eloquent women, being here majority of the time, what's Jack without play? A dull boy, or should I say, a dull girl. Hostel is so much fun, from game nights, movie nights, Miss Castrol pageants, and so much more. And for my ladies who love watching and playing sports, we also have Castrol House Olympics. Hostel truly is a home away from home, and I hope you get to experience the magic too. Thank you.
Good morning, parents. Good morning, children. My name is Suzanne Shebombai, and I'm here to talk to you about hostel and discipline. The MCC Eagle Hostel, which is for the boys, is strategically engineered to build your son. Furthermore, it's built to cater for your son's needs and wants, as Ma'am Vanessa stated before. Eagle House and hostel is away from home, as a home away from home. I know, especially for boys, as they get older, they get more curious and make terrible decisions. However, MCC has you covered. We ensure discipline your little kids and turn them from just little boys into gentlemen of integrity. We have counselors for a more hands-on approach, but trust me, once they're in the nest, you'll see change. Along with these counselors, MCC is equipped with disciplinarians especially picked out to groom little naughty disrespectful Kadai into well-behaved, respectful, honorable Kadai. That's just especially for the boys. When I came to MCC, I was just like them. Literally, I was the naughty, disrespectful Kadai. But MCC grew me to channel that bad energy into singing, and my achievements at MCC on the cultural front really speak for themselves. Would you like to hear them? Okay, well, since you begged. At MCC, I have 7 honors awards in the National Institute of Allied Arts. I'm a 2-time first place public speaker, an MCC ambassador, a steward, head of media and marketing, and an honors winning choir captain. That deserves a round of applause. That's not all. I have traveled to the United States of America to represent the Zimbabwean robotics team, and I've competed against various countries from around the world, and I definitely have more to come. As I stand before you, I am a changed man, but I haven't even started talking about hostel. As we are a Christian school, we always ensure that they are well-versed in the Christian side of things. With devotions in the morning and evening every day, and hostel church on Sundays, our priorities are to ensure that they keep in touch with the Christian side of life. As hostel is a home away from home, we ensure your son is comfortable. As we all know, boys can be boys, and MCC is ready for that preteen energy. We have football tournaments and various activities to keep them occupied on the weekend. Activities such as volleyball, basketball, and game nights on the weekend. Our loving hostel parent, Dr. Sharia, is always ready to be there when we need him, because honestly, we all need someone, right? We have many, many other various features that make Eco House a home away from home. From unlimited Wi-Fi, which ensures we're in touch to academics, as we're in tremulous times with COVID and all, teachers can upload work into Google Classroom so that those in hostel will be able to access with our state-of-the-art Wi-Fi. Hostel, the place to be.
Trust me.
Trust us. Thank you.
All right, there you have it. I did say it's better to hear it from the students. Sometimes one can think, yeah, these guys are making it up, but these guys were telling real stories. I think some of us as parents, you can tell when someone is lying. You know, you can tell when your kids are lying, but these were real issues. This is what we offer, just a snippet of some of what we produce here. This is not even all of them, it's just a handful, but we heard of Zim representatives, we heard of honors winners, etc. There's a lot, and one thing we also want to then do is to even allow you to then tour around the school, go into the classrooms, go to the hostels, just to really have a look and see for yourself. We have nothing to hide, this is who we are, and we are saying partner with us, because this is definitely the school to be at. So now we are done with these presentations. I'll now hand over to the headmaster so that he can also just speak with you. Then we'll talk about other tour issues at the end.
Very good morning to you all, parents and future Eagles. Welcome to Midlands Christian College. We are privileged to have you join us this morning. We understand that midweek programs are usually very difficult with work commitments. I think we're having a bit of a challenge, but I think we'll manage. We thought it would be a good idea for you to hear from the students themselves. Thank you. But also I'd like to, if I can find them, to introduce at least part of the team. Quite often I'm just the face of the school, the guy that gets to sit in the office and drink tea, and if you come and visit the school, I'm the guy that will sit with you in the office and we'll talk stories, get to know each other, understand where you are coming from. If you have any challenges, we talk about that. I'm talking to the parents, especially at this stage. But the presentations that you've just seen show that there is a team behind those young ladies and gentlemen, a team that is working to produce the quality that you've seen this morning. So I'd like to just start off by introducing, well, Mrs. Chimanga, I think, forgot to introduce herself. She is our Director of Cultural Identity, or Culture and Identity, and she handles a lot of our cultural programs and also looks after the culture of who we are as a private ATS college. At the back there, Mrs. Deso, a lady who you saw running around, she is one of our deputy heads. She looks after everything that is non-academic. So everything, even the organization of this morning, which Mrs. Chimanga put together, all that flows into Mrs. Daso's portfolio as well. In front here, we've got Mr. Sachinda, who is our deputy head for academics. And supporting him, we've got Mrs. Sango, who is the girls' affairs director. I'm not sure if Mrs. Sango is here. She might be teaching. She's at the back there. Thank you, Mrs. Sango. And then we've got Dr. Chawira, who looks after the boys' affairs, which is the academic performance of the boys, as well as the discipline of the boys. We also have Mrs. Marconi, who looks after our exams. From the academic presentation that the students made, you'll appreciate that we have quite a wide range of examinations that we run in the college. Basically, most students will write exams every single year with us. So by the time a student gets to the end of the of their 6 years with us, they will have written quite a number of exams. In Form 1, we have students writing HSK Chinese exams, as well as in Form 2 and some in Form 3. In Form 2, we write what we call Cambridge Checkpoint. In Form 3, our students write GCE English, which is an easier English option, and Core Maths. And some will also write combined science at Form 3 level. And then at Form 4 level, they write their full IGCSE exams. And then at Lower 6, we have AS level exams with the final year students writing Cambridge A level exams. Some parents might be keen to understand. You'll be forgiven for thinking that we are just a sporting and cultural school. A lot of parents send their children to school because they want them to perform well academically. However, I've always encouraged parents to look at the bigger picture. Those of you who are employers will understand that if you are presented with two applicants for a job, you will not necessarily go for the one who's got the best intellectual ability. You'll also look at the character of the person sitting in front of you. How well they relate to others. Do they have the right level of emotional intelligence? What is their EQ? The world looks at more than just IQ. What we presented to you this morning are students who are well-rounded. But you might think we're saying that because we don't do a good job academically. Our last year 2021 results, for O-level or IGCSE, we had 65 students entering the exams. 72 A stars, 137 A symbols, and 164 Bs. This is for a school that takes students of different abilities. I had a discussion with one parent earlier on, and they asked me, well, do you only take students with ones at grade 7? And I said, no, we don't. We accept all students of different abilities. That is one of the unique have what they have to give, and will squeeze the best out of each child. And I specifically use the word squeeze. I think our deputy head girl, Vanessa, talked about the process of how a pearl is made. Similarly, a diamond is made under pressure. And make no apologies that we will put your young ones under pressure, pressure that is good for them. We will not allow them to break. This is not to break them, but it is to mold them into some of the young ladies and gentlemen that you saw earlier. At AS level, we had a 98% pass rate, and A level, 96% pass rate. At AS level, we had two students with 23 A's and 25 B symbols. Our best results, one of our students had 22 points, one had 20 points, with two students with 18 points, and two with 17 points. Now, those of you who went to school a long time ago, like myself, these numbers will be quite baffling to you. We would celebrate students who had 15 points, and we still do. But we are coming up with even better performances than what us as parents used to produce. I was just laughing when Sharon was talking about every child saying, or every parent telling their child that they were always at the top of the class. So, we are more than just an academic school. MCC is a private Christian institution, but we have truly become an international school. A lot of the students that you saw are actually not from Zimbabwe, and those who might be from Zimbabwe, some of them are actually based outside the country. So we take students from different parts of the world. We have students from Australia, from the UK, from South Africa, from Malawi, from Botswana, from Zambia, from Mozambique, from different countries. I think we've just added one from Canada as well. So it's very important that as parents, as you are joining the MCC family, that you understand it is just that, it's a family. We are a family, we are a community. Unfortunately, because of COVID, we have not been able to fully express that aspect of our identity. As COVID comes to an end, or we learn to live with COVID, we will be coming together in various ways to celebrate our sense of community and to learn from each other. Mrs. Chimanga earlier on spoke about the aspect of partnership. We would like to invite you to partner with us in the education of your child. This is a partnership in the sense that the school alone cannot do it. Last year was a very challenging year for us, and the partnership was put to the test. By the time our students wrote exams, they had spent only 4 months at school out of the 10 months up until October. So for 6 months of the year, they were at home. We couldn't produce the results that we have now produced if it wasn't for that partnership. I would like to just highlight those of you that haven't had the opportunity to look at our website, www.mcc.ac.zw. This gives you an opportunity to learn a little bit more about our school and what the college is all about. But I'd like to just move on and talk slightly to our students, the future Eagles, and talk about what the Eagle spirit is about. Our school verse is Isaiah 40, verse 31. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. That is key. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Whatever we do in the name of the Lord, and we are very unapologetic about that. This is who we are as a Christian school. Now, some people think Christian school means perfect school. I don't think so. I'm not a perfect headmaster. We do not have perfect teachers. We do not have perfect students.
and you also don't have perfect parents. Therefore, we cannot have a perfect school, but we will have a school that is molded in the way that the Lord wants us to go. So the Eagles Creed will teach you, future Eagles, to be focused, to put God at the center of everything that you do, to be responsible citizens, citizens of God's kingdom, citizens of the beautiful country of Zimbabwe, and citizens of the world. We will teach you to be teachable, secure, and adaptable, to be critical thinkers, to be exemplary leaders, to be confident team players, to engage in a healthy, physically active lifestyle. As an eagle, we will teach you to ride the storm. The eagle doesn't run away from the storm. The eagle flies into the storm and looks forward to the challenge of the storm. So, grade sevens, grade sixes and sevens, we hope that you will choose Midlands Christian College as your school. If you're a sportsman, we will develop your sporting ability to the best level that you can go to. If you're an academic, we'll make sure that you get the grades that you aspire. If you're a culturally inclined person, you like singing, you like drama, you like playing a musical instrument, or you'd like to learn one, we will teach you that. Above all, we will teach you to be a lady, and we will teach you to be a gentleman. Parents, you might be wondering what the big question, the dollar sign question. What are your fees? Our fees for tuition are 1,667, for boarding an additional 1,740, plus an additional laundry fee of $120. Now remember, I said we're a family. We're trying to build a partnership. So we are prepared to sit and have a discussion around terms. We're prepared to sit and have a discussion around how else we can make the load lighter for you as parents. So we encourage parents not to just shy away and say, ooh, those figures sound a little bit steep. If you look at the quality of what we are producing, and you consider those figures in the right light as an investment rather than a cost, you realize that it's worth it. Some of us like to put money in different investments, investment vehicles, or you might buy a property as an investment. Those of you who are accountants will understand the concept of assets. We believe that your most important asset as a parent is your child. And investing into the life and future of your child is the most important investment you can make. So with that, I invite you to truly consider being part of our family, being part of our community. I think we are running a few minutes behind. I was going to play a video just to encourage the students on, but maybe we can do that towards the end, an Eagles Creed video, just to get you excited about what this Eagle culture is about. It's a brand. If you come and join us, you'll be joining one of the strongest school brands, not only in Zimbabwe, but in Southern Africa and beyond. So we hope as you go on the tour that you will enjoy the tour of our facilities, and we hope that we will see you all at the end of the year, or maybe at the end of the year, yes, when you come for your orientation after having been offered a place at Midlands Christian College. If I can just also talk about the process very briefly of enrollment. This is the first stage. You come to open day. We have another open day. If you have any friends who you feel missed out on this, we have another opportunity online tomorrow. Mrs. Chimanga or Mrs. Daiso can give you the details. And this is especially aimed at those people living outside the country. But those living in Zimbabwe who didn't manage to come are also welcome to that. At some stage, probably June, July, we are going to have what we call a common assessment paper. All ATS schools, Association of Trust Schools, high schools, will invite students to write this common assessment paper. In order for you to qualify for that exam, we've put an application form in the folders that we've handed out. Please fill it in and leave it behind and indicate there Midlands Christian College first choice, so that we can then invite you or your child to come and write the common assessment paper with us. After we've done that, then we'll go through the process of selecting the students who will join us. We're looking for three classes of 30, which is 90 students. So, and remember I said we don't necessarily just take the best students, so it's good that you get in before anybody else does. Once we have written the common assessment paper, we will use those results not so much for excluding some students, but for setting purposes, to know which students will go into which set. Thereafter, we'll indicate when our orientation day is, where those who have been offered a place will be invited back, and we'll sit with you and go through the nitty-gritties of what is about to come to MCC. Today is just a little taster, but when you come for orientation, we'll give you a lot more information, and you will be introduced to life at MCC with the objective of you starting in January 2023. So with those few words, thank you very much. I'll hand you back to